Grimm's Hall title, The Fisherman and His Wife by the Brothers Grimm. We hope you enjoy the performance.
Once upon a time, there lived a fisherman and his wife. They lived in a hut by the sea. Their hut was small and they didn't have much money, but they were very happy.
Ah, my good wife, smell that air. I am so happy here in our hut by the sea.
Me too, my husband. We have a roof over our heads and he always brings us fish to eat.
We are very lucky.
Yes, we are.
One day, like every other day, the fisher is fishing in his little boat on the sea.
Suddenly, he felt something tugging on his line. The tugging was so strong, he almost fell out of his boat.
Wow! This must be some fish!
The fisherman pulled and pulled his line, trying to get the fish out of the water.
Finally, the fisherman pulled the fish out.
Wow! This is some fish indeed!
Yes, I am. Now please let me go.
Well, I can't do that because... Hey, wait a minute. A talking fish?
I am not only a talking fish, I'm a magical fish. I can give you whatever you like.
That sounds a bit fishy if you ask me.
It's true, so what would you like?
Well, let me think. You know, I am so happy with what I already have, I can't think of anything to wish for. But I will let you go anyway.
The fisherman unhooked the fisherman's line.
Bye-bye. Thank you, kind sir.
And with that, the fish swam away deep down under the water.
The fisherman hurried home to tell his wife what had happened.
What happened? The most amazing thing has happened.
What is it, dear? Did you catch a fish?
No, I didn't catch any, but I met a talking fish, a magic fish. She said I had anything to wish for.
How wonderful. So what did she ask this magic fish for?
Nothing. I told her I was happy with what I have.
True, we are happy, but there could have been something you could wish for. What about a new house?
But I thought you were happy in our hut.
I am, but a lovely cottage might be even happier. Please, husband, go see if you can for a lovely cottage.
If you wish.
So the fisher set out again to find the magic fish.
He stood in his boat and called out to the fish.
Yoo-hoo, magic fish, come out of the sea. My wife has a wish, so she has sent me.
The fish popped her head out of the water.
What is her wish, my kind friend?
She would like a lovely cottage.
That would be go home and I'll find one.
And the fish swam away deep down under the water.
The fisher had heard hope to see if his wish actually came true.
He couldn't believe what he saw. His wife was sitting in front of a beautiful cottage.
Welcome to our new home, my husband. Your fish has done a wonderful job.
That she has. She was very kind. Oh, you'll be so happy in this cottage.
Well, yes.
But what?
This cottage is indeed lovely, but it is a little small. I would like to live in a magnificent castle.
A castle? What would you do with the castle?
Please, husband. Then I'll be happy.
If you wish.
So the fisher set off again to find a magical fish.
He rowed his boat to the middle of the sea and called for the fish.
Yoo-hoo, magic fish, come out of the sea. My wife has a wish, she has sent me.
The fish popped her head out of the water.
Another wish? Doesn't she like the cottage?
Oh, the cottage is indeed lovely, but now she would like to a magnificent castle.
So it'd be go for me to find one.
Castle?
Yes, it is. The fish has done a great job.
Yes.
But what?
What good is it being a castle if you're a king?
But I don't want to be king.
Well, if you don't, I do. Go to fish and make me queen.
But I have already asked her for too much. I can't ask her for any more.
Please, husband. Then I'll be happy.
Well, all right. But this is the last time.
So the fisherman caught the fish one more time.
Yoo-hoo! Magic fish, come out of the sea! My wife has a wish! She has sent me!
The fish popped her head out of the water.
What do you want now? Isn't the castle enough?
Oh, the castle is very lovely, but now she would like to be queen.
Queen? Isn't she happy being a fisherman's wife?
I thought she was, but I guess she wants more now.
So it'd be, go home and you'll find one.
Oh, thank you, dear fish! You are most kind!
No problem.
And the fish went way deep down under the water.
The fisherman hurried home to see if his wish had come true. Was his wife being made queen?
As soon as he saw his wife, he knew that the answer was yes. She was sitting down on a golden throne, wearing a beautiful jewel crown.
Wife, are you really made queen?
I am, and you must call me Your Majesty.
Yes, Your Majesty, and are you happy being queen?
Well, yes.
But don't tell me!
Well, it is good to rule over all the people, but I want to be even more powerful. I want to rule the sun and the moon and all the planets.
Why?
I mean, want. I will not. You are not being fair.
You do as I say. I am your queen.
Yes, your majesty.
So the fisherman wildly caught the fish again.
Yoo-hoo! Magic fish, come out of the sea, but if his wish, she sent me.
The fish popped her head out of the water.
I don't believe it. What does she want now?
My dear fish friend, I am so sorry to keep on bothering you, but now she would like to roll. Now she would like to roll over the sun and the moon and the planets that I'm guessing she doesn't know.
Enough is enough. Your wife is no longer queen, no more castle, and I'm out of service, y'all. The fisherman returned home. Many years passed. The fisherman and his wife were still living in their hut.
Husband, it has been many years since you met the magic fish. Since then, nothing has changed. We live in the same hut by the sea. You go fishing every day. I keep a hut clean. I prepare fine meals for us. And guess what?
I don't believe it! Would you like a palace? A carriage? Would you like to go over the fish as well?
I don't want anything else. Nor do I, my wife. We have everything we need.
So if you're ever down by the sea, look for a small hut.
And there you will find a very happy fisherman and his very happy wife.
The end!
Good job.